I'm ready. Let's go. Wait, you're not doing anything here. What's going on? You ready? You ready to lead worship? Wait, I'm supposed to lead worship. No one told me that. I thought the citizens were leading worship today, and that's why I was a little late. I'm sorry I was late, but I thought you were doing it. Okay, we gotta figure out something. Maybe I'll say something like this. It's time for worship. I'm being silly. I do have a few things prepared for worship. Don't worry. I got it. I'll do it. Well, welcome to worship, everybody. And happy Sunday afternoon to you. We are doing worship on YouTube for a few weeks here. So we are being extra safe for a few weeks. And we have kind of some progress needing to be made with the virus, and some progress is being made, and we just gotta wait a little bit longer to be back in the chapel. And I'm excited to be back in the chapel. They're still working on a couple things there too, so this actually works out with the timing where they can finish everything at the chapel and we will be back in the chapel together very soon. I'm excited for that. So we're just doing this week, next week, just a few worship onlines, and that's all right. We can worship together. It's not the building that's the church. It's the people, right? So wherever we are at, we can worship God together in spirit and in truth. So with that in mind, will you open in prayer with me? God, we are grateful to you for your goodness and your greatness and how you have blessed us in so many ways. And we pray that you would help us to worship you today in spirit and in truth, wherever we might be at, our living room, our bedroom, our dining room, wherever it is, we worship you today. And it's in your name we pray. Amen. Well, hey, our call to worship today is from Psalm 100. I don't know, it's gotten into me, y'all. I'm just being weird today. Psalm 100 says this: Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Oh, and you can only do this at the chapel. No, it doesn't say that. You can do it anywhere. It says, enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. In other words, God's good. We should praise him. So let's praise him with some music. Here we go.
I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I need him, he's always near. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives. In all the world around me, I see his love and care. And though my heart grows weary, I never will despair. I know that he is leading through all the stormy blast. The day of his appearing will come at last. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart. Rejoice, rejoice, O Christian, lift up your voice and sing. Eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King, the hope of all who seek Him, the help of all who find. None other is so loving, so good and kind. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart.
Praise the Lord. Sing this chorus together. It says, I just wanna praise you. Come on, clap your hands with us. And ever.
And ever.
And ever.
And ever.
It says, for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory. Jesus, say for blessing me. Let's sing it together, church. Lift your voice. I just wanna praise you forever, Jesus. We praise your name forever and ever. For all you've done for me. Have you been good to your church? Father, we bless your name today. Your voice and say blessings and glory. All of the honor, Jesus, it belongs to you. Say thank you, Jesus. Say for blessing me. Come on, clap your hands. Let's sing it again, church. I just wanna praise you, Lord. Say praise your name forever. Lift your name, Jesus. I gotta lift your name, Jesus. For all you've done, you've been so faithful, Lord. Made a way out of no way. Just for me, just for me. Hey, blessings and glory. Hey, all the honor, Lord. It belongs to Jesus. Say, thank you, Jesus. Done for me.
Amen. Amen. Well, do me a favor and either say it back to me if you're watching this alone, or if you're watching this with other people, turn to the other people watching with you and say, peace be with you. Peace be with you. Yes, you. Peace be with you. All right. Well, thank you for helping me with that. It's fun to and good to pass God's peace to one another and just wish God's peace upon each other. I wish it upon you and pray for peace for you. Our core value this week, we each week just review a core value. And our core value this coming week is opportunity. As in, I have the opportunity to worship with you today. Opportunity at Brookwood, though, specifically, means giving each other every chance to do good. So y'all give me the opportunity to share a message each Sunday. Thank you for that opportunity. You give me that chance to do good. I hope I take that opportunity. We give each other every opportunity to do good. We don't give up on each other. We don't assume that each other can't do it. We give each other opportunities. That's one of the things I love about Brookwood. In our scripture reading for today, our scripture reading for today is from 1 Samuel 2, verses 9 through 10. It says this: it is not by strength that one prevails. Those who oppose the Lord, even if they're strong, will be broken. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, y'all, faith is more important than looks. I'm seeing if I don't have one. I was looking for a mirror, but I don't have a mirror. Faith is more important than looks. That's one of the main messages of the book of 1 Samuel, that faith in God is way more important than how you look or how your situation looks or anything like that. Faith is really important. Now, last week, you might remember I had a Captain America shirt on. I don't have it on today. I should, because of our message today, but can't have everything in life. We talked about Captain America. What are some things you know about Captain America? Is Captain America fast? Yeah. He's speedy. Is Captain America smart? Yeah, he's pretty smart. Is Captain America a great leader? Of course, he's Captain America. Is Captain America strong? Yeah, Captain America is very strong, supernaturally strong, in fact. But here is our devotional thought of the week this week. Faith in God is stronger than Captain America. Whoa. Faith in God is stronger than Captain America. Why would I say that, and how can I say that? Well, that's kind of what I get from 1 Samuel 2. It doesn't talk about Captain America, obviously, in the Bible. But faith is just so strong. You can just take Captain America. He's really strong, but faith is stronger than him. But if we look at 1 Samuel 2, you remember what happens in 1 Samuel 1. There's a woman named Hannah. She wants to have a child. She can't. She's getting teased. She prays to God to give her a child, and God answers her prayer, gives her a son named Samuel. And Samuel, she dedicates Samuel's life to God, and Samuel's going to live with the priests and learn how to be a priest and how to serve God. And in 1 Samuel 2, after all of this has happened, Hannah prays. And this chapter is just what Hannah says in her prayer. In 1 Samuel 2, verse 1, here is what This is how Hannah starts her prayer. She says, "My heart rejoices in the Lord. In the Lord my horn is lifted up." That means my spirits are lifted up. "My mouth boasts over my enemies, for I delight in your deliverance, O God." So what Hannah is doing here, what she's saying is that she's boasting. She's acting like a warrior. Okay, so in olden times, back in the day, during ancient Israel, ancient Greece, ancient Rome, ancient Persia, you know, way back thousands of years, what you did if you were a warrior, you were a strong warrior, you're about to go into battle, all right? What you would do is you would walk up to the enemy or you'd shout across the field to the enemy and you would say, "I am Anthony. I am the strongest man of the Eastland. No man can stand against me." You would boast. You would brag about yourself. You would try and scare the other person. You would try and scare the other army so that either they ran away or they wouldn't fight very well because they were kind of afraid. You would boast. So what Hannah is doing here is she is boasting. She's saying, "Man, God's taking care of me. And no one can stand up against me because God is with me." She's just this little unknown woman, but don't be deceived by looks. She's acting like a warrior. She is strong now because she has faith in God. The reason she's acting so strong is verse 2. She says, "There is no one holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you. There is no rock like our God." She is depending on God. She has her faith in God. And because of that, she has confidence and she's strong. And then later in the prayer, she starts talking to people who are bragging on themselves. She's saying, "Hey, you people who think you're so strong. Hey, you people who think you're so good looking. Hey, you people who are so rich and you depend on your riches." That isn't nothing compared to God. And she makes it clear that God is who gives strength and who gives victory. There's nothing else that you can depend on quite like God. So what she's saying and what we need to realize, you watching this, you need to realize this, that it is not about how smart you are. It is not about how good looking you are. It is not about how rich you are or how popular you are or how famous you are. It's about how much faith in God you have. Do you have faith in God? Do you trust Him for your salvation, for your life, for guiding you, for providing for you, for protecting you, for giving you eternal life through Jesus? Do you trust Him for all that? If you do, there's great strength in that. There's great power in faith in God. Hannah knew it, and she experienced it. And we can experience the same thing. When we put our faith in God and we follow Him and obey Him, even when it doesn't look good because we have faith in Him, God will take care of us, God will provide for us, and God will allow us to do great and amazing things for His name. Faith in God is stronger than Captain America. It really is. And Jesus is who we put our faith in. He died on the cross for our sins. He rose from the grave. And through faith in Him, we are forgiven of our sins. We are made righteous. We are given eternal life. We become a part of God's family through faith in Christ. Faith in God is stronger than Captain America. So with that, I would like to sing another song of praise to the God that we put our faith in. So let's sing one more song of worship.
Hail Jesus, you're my King.
Hail Jesus, you're my King.
Your life frees me to sing.
Your life frees me to sing.
I will praise you all my days.
I will praise you all my days.
You're perfect in all your ways.
You're perfect in all your ways.
Hail Jesus, you're my Lord.
Hail Jesus, you're my Lord.
I will obey your word. I want to see your kingdom come.
I want to see your kingdom come.
Not my will, but yours be done.
Not my will, but yours be done.
Glory, glory to the Lamb.
Glory, glory to the Lamb.
You take me into the Lamb. And we will conquer in your name.
Jesus reigns.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah.
How powerful you
are.
Hail, Lion of Judah.
How wonderful you
are.
How wonderful you are.
Well, our devotional thought of the week, remember, is faith in God is stronger than Captain America. And we're going to be talking about that in your work studios and at home in the evening. And you can share that with your work program teachers and RAs and home teachers and everybody you see. You can share that. Hey! Faith in God is stronger than Captain America. You can tell somebody that this week. And just be on the lookout for that. But let's close in prayer for now. Would you pray with me? God, you are great. And we pray that you would help us to have faith in you. We trust you. We put our faith in you. And we pray that you would bless and guide us this week. Help us to do your will and to glorify you. It's in your name we pray. Amen. God bless.